Dear students, I am K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvinni. This is the lecture number 1 on steam turbine. In the earlier semester, third semester, we studied the hydraulic turbine, which is a machine. Hydraulic turbine is a machine which produces mechanical work from hydraulic energy. Similarly, steam turbine is a machine which produces mechanical work from the steam energy, that is enthalpy of the steam. The steam enthalpy content or the heat content of the steam is measured in terms of enthalpy, which is a function of pressure and temperature. So when the pressure and temperatures are high, the enthalpy of the steam will be high. When the steam is superheated, the enthalpy of the steam will be high. So it can, the turbine will produce higher power. So steam turbine, basically a machine which is producing mechanical power from steam energy, that is particularly heat energy of the steam. So we go back to the heat engine, definition of the heat engine. The engine is a device which is producing mechanical energy. A heat engine is a device which is producing mechanical energy from heat energy. And the heat engines are classified into two types, internal combustion engine and external combustion engine. Internal combustion engine, so the combustion of the fuel takes place inside the cylinder of engine. Or external combustion engine, the combustion of the fuel is taking place outside the engine. And there is another classification of heat engine. It may be reciprocating engine or rotary engine. So reciprocating engine, it consists of a piston cylinder arrangement. The piston reciprocates inside the cylinder to convert the heat energy into mechanical energy. So rotary engine, it is rotating. You have a rotor. So rotor is rotating because of the heat energy, expanding the heat energy, reducing the heat energy. So it is rotary type of engine. We have different types. Reciprocating internal combustion engine. The examples are petrol engine, diesel engine, or the gas engine. We studied earlier in the fourth semester, petrol engine, diesel engine, and the gas engine working. And rotary internal combustion engine, Wankel engine, open cycle gas turbine. So the rotary internal combustion engine. So gas turbine is the rotating machine. And the Wankel engine is also a rotating machine. And reciprocating external combustion engine, they are steam engine and Stirling engine. Steam engine nowadays we are not using. So earlier steam engine was used in the train. Nowadays it is not used in the larger scale. Rotary external combustion engine, steam turbine or a closed cycle gas turbine. So turbine is a rotating machine. So the steam turbine is a rotating type of machine, external combustion rotary engine. So we will study the steam turbine in detail. The counterpart of the steam turbine is the steam engine. So earlier in the Industrial Revolution, first the steam engine was invented, which was used for mobility. So for the train, we were using steam engine. Later on, by invention of the steam turbine, the steam turbine is particularly used for power generation at a larger scale from the steam energy. So enthalpy of the steam, you have a huge boiler which produces steam, then the steam is utilized in the steam turbine to produce the mechanical power. And then it goes to the condenser and the pump and given back to the boiler. So you just recall the Rankine cycle, basic Rankine cycle. So in the Rankine cycle, the steam turbine is a component. The advantages of the steam turbine are over the steam engines are, the efficiency of the steam turbine is higher. The steam consumption is less per unit power. So comparing with the steam engine, the amount of steam consumed per unit power is less in the case of steam turbine. It requires lesser space and lighter foundation because the foundation depends on the kind of operation. So reciprocating engine, there will be more vibration. You require strong foundation, and rotary machines, there is no vibration. So we require only lighter foundation. The steam turbine is safe because all the parts are enclosed in the casing. The rotor, nozzle, everything is enclosed in a casing. It is safe. The maintenance cost is less because there is no reciprocating component. So these are all the advantages of the steam turbine over steam engine. And look at the diagram. So this is the construction of a industrial steam turbine. The various components are steam pipeline, inlet control valve, nozzle chamber, nozzle box, nozzle outlet, stator, blade carrier, casing, rotor disc, right? Rotor, journal bearing, thrust bearing, generator, rotor, coupling, labneth packing, steam bleeding, extraction point, bearing pedestal, safety governor, main oil pump, centrifugal governor, turning gear, control stage impulse bleeding. So these are all the various components. And the main part is, this is what the main, where you have the rotor and the nozzle, right? So we will see another diagram. This is the rotor of a steam turbine, industrial steam turbine. Look at the construction, the diameter of the rotor. So steam enters here and flows in this direction. And similarly, steam enters here, flows in the opposite direction. If you look at the height of the rotor in the direction of the steam flow is increasing. Why? So because of the expansion, the steam expansion, the specific volume of the steam, so expansion, specific volume or density of the steam decreases. So we require larger area to handle the steam. So density decreases or specific volume increases. So we require larger space for the accommodate the steam. So that is why we have a diverging passage for the steam turbine. So this is another diagram, another image of the rotor. So you look at the rotor blade. So this is of aerofoil shape. This is the rotor blade. These are for aerofoil shape. And look at this diagram, this image. So it is a huge structure. The rotor of the steam turbine is a huge structure for higher power generation. So if you look, so these are all called as twisted blades. For three-dimensional flow, we have the twisted blade. So this is what the rotor blade or rotor of a steam turbine. So how do we classify the steam turbine? So the first classification, mode of steam action, maybe impulse turbine or reaction turbine. We'll take one by one. So mode of steam action, maybe impulse turbine or reaction turbine. So look at this diagram. We have a rotor. It just resembles the Pelton turbine. Pelton turbine, which is hydraulic turbine of impulse type. So you have a nozzle. So, and a rotor. So, the steam from here, it enters, flows through the nozzle, and the steam jet is leaving. So, jet of steam is leaving, and it rotates the rotor. So, the jet impinges, jet of steam impinges on the rotor, make the rotor to rotate. This is what the impulse principle, and this is called as impulse turbine. And look at this diagram. So, you have a rotor, and the steam enters at the center, flows in this direction. You have the nozzle, here you have the nozzle, here you have the nozzle. Steam leaves through the nozzle, velocity is generated. So the steam velocity makes the rotor to rotate. So the rotor is rotating because of the reaction of the jet. So that is why it is called as reaction turbine. And the direction of the flow, look at this diagram. So the velocity, the steam enters with the velocity, velocity is C1, and any, this is a velocity vector, it has got three directions. What are the three directions? This is Cx, axial direction, parallel to the axis of the machine, and Cr, radial direction, perpendicular to the axis or parallel to the radius of the machine, and one more direction is tangential direction. So the axial, radial, and tangential. So the flow, when the flow is axial, parallel to the axis, so enters in the axial direction, leaves in the axial direction. Majority of the steam turbine used in the industries, they are axial flow turbine. That is called as axial flow turbine. Radial flow turbine enters center and leaves vertically. So flows in the radial direction. That is called the radial flow turbine. So the axial flow turbine, steam flows parallel to the axis. Radial flow turbine, steam flows in the radial direction. pressure of the steam. This may be high pressure turbine when the pressure is greater than 40 bar, medium pressure turbine when the pressure is between 20 and 2 and 40 bar, or low pressure turbine when the pressure is less than 2 bar. Then the exhaust condition of the steam. This may be a condensing turbine or non-condensing turbine. What is condensing turbine? The steam outlet from the turbine is goes to the condenser and condensed and recirculated back to the boiler. That is called as condensing turbine. Non-condensing turbine, the steam from the turbine is used for industrial purpose. It is not condensed and recirculated. So the steam outlet from the steam turbine is used for industrial purpose, industrial processing, then it is called as non-condensing turbine. So number of stages, this may be single stage or multi-stage turbine. Single stage means there will be single rotor. Multi-stage means there are multiple rotors. Method of governing, the turbine may be turbine with the throttle governing, turbine may be with the nozzle governing, or turbine with the bypass governing. These are the different types of governing methodologies. So, mode of steam action, direction of the flow, pressure of the steam, exhaust condition of the steam, number of stages, method of governing. These are the title by which the steam turbines are classified. So, we will take the single stage impulse turbine. Look at the diagram. So, single stage, there is one set of nozzle and one set of moving blade. D level, the first turbine, invented the first turbine, single stage impulse turbine. So, the single stage impulse turbine is normally known as D level turbine. So, the steam from the boiler. So, what is the construction? Look at the diagram. You have a set of nozzle and set of moving blade. So, the steam flows through the nozzle first and then moving blade and then leaves. So, in a single stage. If you have a multi-stage, then again you will have a nozzle and then it flows back, flows again to the moving blade. So, in a single stage turbine, we have a nozzle and the moving blade. Now, look at the pressure. So, the steam enters with the higher pressure, boiler pressure. Pressure decreases. So, across the nozzle, pressure decreases and the pressure remains constant in the moving blade. So, pressure from the boiler pressure reduced to condenser pressure and pressure remains constant in the moving blade. This is the important point that you have to remember. Pressure remains constant across the moving blade in the case of impulse turbine. And look at the velocity variation. So, inlet velocity is less. Normally, inlet velocity at the entry of the nozzle is less. The pressure drop. So, the pressure drop in the nozzle is converted into velocity increase in kinetic energy or velocity. So, the velocity, high velocity, steam with high velocity, it is impinging on the rotor blade. So, velocity is decreasing and the decrease in velocity, it is what converted into work done by the moving blade. So, the change in the kinetic energy is converted into work done using the Newton's second law of motion. So, the outlet velocity decreases, lower velocity. So, you remember the construction, you have a set of nozzle and set of moving blade, how the pressure is changing across the stage and how the velocity is changing across the stage. That is what you have to remember. And D level turbine is the single stage impulse turbine. Okay, we'll take a quiz to understand, to evaluate our understanding. You have a quiz. You take a moment and answer the question. So, if your answer is B, total enthalpy drop occurs only in the nozzle in the case of impulse turbine, you are good, you are correct. The second question, D level turbine is a pressure compounded impulse turbine, velocity compounded impulse turbine, single stage impulse turbine, single stage reaction turbine. So, if your answer is C, single stage impulse turbine, again you are correct. The pressure on two sides of the impulse turbine rotor is the same, different, increase from one side to another, decrease from one side to another. If your answer is the same, A, you are correct. Considering the variation of static pressure and absolute velocity in an impulse turbine across one row of the moving blade, both the pressure and velocity decreases. pressure decreases but velocity increases. Pressure remains constant while velocity increases. Pressure remains constant while velocity decreases. So if your answer is B, pressure remains constant while velocity decreases, you are correct.